How's it going, everybody? It's Jesse, and I'm on here a little tiny bit late than what I usually jump on here for our live stream today. I want to make sure that we got people on here, so I'm going to give it about a minute or so before I really get into it. Hopefully, you guys can see me. Looks like we've got, all right, we got a few viewers. How's it going, everybody? It's Jesse, and I'm on here a little bit late today. I apologize. I had a bunch of technical difficulties to deal with regarding my audio. Wasn't able to resolve the issue. So, unfortunately, I'm going to have to do this the old-fashioned way. By old-fashioned, I mean about a month ago when I was doing the live streams with just one camera. I'm going to give it about 2 or 3 minutes before we really get started here. But I apologize. I usually jump on here about 10 minutes early. But like I said, I could not figure out my audio earlier today, so I was trying to do it the fancy way where I have both of my live streams, so two cameras at the same time. Anyway, it's going to be okay. Everything's going to be okay, regardless of how we do this. Please let me know. Give me a thumbs up and let me know that you can hear me. Okay? I already see some scammers in the feed, so please do not feed the animals. Don't go and click on those links. Give me 1 second while I delete this comment. So we got some scammers already in the comment section. Okay, stay away from them. All right, hold on. All they do is come on here and distract things. So let me know, guys, if you can hear me okay. Please let me know if you can hear me okay. Give me a thumbs up. Actually, tell them to just say, I can. Okay, here we go. I see Green SCTS says, I can hear you. All right, fantastic. So we're going to give it a couple of minutes, folks. Like I said, usually I jump on here a couple of 10 minutes early, not a couple, but about 10, 15 minutes early. Today I tried to do that. I was experiencing some audio difficulties with my setup. Wasn't able to resolve it. So anyway, here we are doing this the old-fashioned way, which basically means we're doing it with one camera instead of two, which is perfectly fine. We're not going to have any issues with that. But again, just want to remind everybody, please do not communicate with the scammers in the comment section. They like to put links on there to try to lead you away from our live stream. Completely ignore those and just have fun. It's all going to happen right here live on Facebook and on YouTube. We're on both today. Let's see. We got a few people watching on YouTube and quite a few people watching on Facebook. Anyway, folks, we're going to get moving here pretty fast. I don't want to waste too much time. We're already starting a little bit behind. But obviously what we're going to be painting today, you guys are all here for our little busy bee painting for today. Okay? Of course, I walk you step by step through the entire process. What are you going to be using today? You're going to be using a pencil. Okay? Pencil to draw or chalk. If you have a piece of chalk, chalk works perfect. Fine. Then, of course, some paints. I'll talk about the paints here just a little bit. I'm using acrylic paints. The colors that I'll be using are light blue, some white, some yellow, pink, black, brown, green, and a dark blue. Once again, those colors, light blue, white, yellow, pink, black, brown, green, and a dark blue. The white is just to lighten up some of my colors. I don't know that I'll be using the white too much. Whatever color you guys have, whatever colors you have, don't worry about it. You're going to be fine with whatever you've got. If you want to modify the piece in any way, shape, or form, it's absolutely up to you to do just that. Okay, have fun with it. Get creative. You guys already know. Those of you that have been here on my page before, you guys already know how this works. I do have some paper towels here to help with the messes, and I also use these to clean up my brushes and steps. I've got a set of brushes that I'll give you guys a close-up of here in a little bit, but I've just got a few basic brushes in here. I've got a water cup. My brushes sit inside the water cup in between its steps simply to keep them from drying out because we are using acrylic paint. Very important that you have your brushes sitting in water in between steps. Okay, when I outline the step up here in a little bit, once we get moving, I'm going to have the camera up nice and tight, real close to the to my canvas. Of course, I'm using a little 8x10-inch canvas, same size as the original. But once we get moving, the camera comes in really tight to my canvas, and you guys are able to see really up close what it is that I'm doing, okay? So anyway, just want to say thank you to all of you. for being here today. I really appreciate it. You guys are on Painting with Jesse, and I just want to really quickly go through some of the stuff that we're going to be doing here over the next few weeks. I've got an event on Wednesday, a Blue Jays event. I'm going to teach you how to draw and paint Blue Jays. I don't have a painting with me, but if you guys are interested, actually, is it behind me? No, it's not. If you guys are interested, go check out the event page. Again, on Wednesday, this coming Wednesday, I've got a really nice Blue Jays painting. I'll look for the painting here just a little bit. If I've got it, I'll show it to you guys. But here are some of the stuff that's coming up over the next few weeks. On March 2nd, Tuesday, March 2nd, okay, Dr. Seuss's birthday, I'm going to be teaching you how to draw completely from scratch. This little piece here, okay, Cat in the Hat. Again, March 2nd, Tuesday, March 2nd, Dr. Seuss's birthday. Okay, the event is already listed. You guys can go check out all the details. All right, I don't remember the date on this, but it's the same week. I believe it's the Friday or Saturday that weekend. Following the Dr. Seuss painting, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to draw and how to paint this cute little spring Easter rabbit completely from scratch. We painted from scratch. All that good stuff. Again, this event is also under the event tab. Go check that out so you get all the details. And then we got little Valentine's, not Valentine's, our St. Patrick's Nomies that we're going to also be doing. There's a lot more coming up through the month. I haven't listed everything. But we also got a little leprechaun on March 17th, St. Patrick's Day. We're going to be doing that little leprechaun. And then the same week, sometime later in the week, this is the way. Okay, you guys see that? This is the way. The Mandalorian and Little Grogu. Okay? So anyway, those are some of the events that are coming up. There's a lot more that I'm going to be posting here pretty soon. So obviously, look out for that. If you guys haven't yet, please follow the page so that you get the notifications every time I post something. All right. So here we go. Let's get moving here. I'm going to take a moment here to come around to the front. I got to situate everything like I used to do it before I had the two cameras set up. Basically, I come around to the front. I'm going to bring everything in nice and tight so you guys get a really good close-up of what it is that I'm doing. Okay, so bear with me a little bit while I do all of this. In the meantime, you guys want to get your paints ready, get your colors ready. Again, you guys can change things up. Don't stress too much about using the exact same colors that I'm using. Whatever it is that you have will be perfect. Fine. If you're not using acrylic paints, maybe you're using watercolors, maybe you're going to be using crayons, colored pencils, etc., etc., etc. Everything is perfectly okay as long as you're comfortable and happy. That's all that really matters. We're going to have some fun here. Give me a second. I'm going to remove my microphone. And let's get a really tight close-up of what we got here. All right, here we go. So this setup here is a little bit old school. Here we go. Again, I was hoping I'd be able to use the setup that I've been using, but it didn't quite work out. My audio was giving me this weird echo, and I couldn't figure out why. So anyhow, no big deal. We'll figure it out. I'm going to be teaching you guys how to draw things, everything first. Okay, I'll be teaching you. I'm going to be using a pencil to do my drawing part of it. Sometimes those of you that have been painting with me for a while know that sometimes I use a chalk, or this I'm going to be using a pencil. Okay, and again, I'm going to be drawing first. Sometimes I'll do the background first, other times I will do the drawing part of it first, and that's what we're going to be doing today. Give me one sec, one last little setup here, one last little adjustment, and I think we're good. Sorry about all the wiggling. There we go. That's better. Sorry, folks, all the wiggling around of the camera here. Almost there, promise. Almost there. All right, that's gonna have to do right there. All right, everyone. So let's look at our little piece here. I'll be looking at the comments and saying hello to a bunch of you. I got some shout outs to make in just a bit. But first, we're gonna get right into the drawing part of it. Pretty basic. Like I mentioned, I've got an 8x10 inch canvas here. Whatever size you've got, you go ahead and make the adjustments. Pretty basic. There isn't anything too crazy about our little drawing today, our little painting. Whoops. There we go. Let's take a look. So we're going to start with a little flower. Down here in the corner, we got this little, we're going to start with the center of our flower, which is basically a circle. Okay, so that's what I'm going to draw here. Grab my pencil, nice and light. Remember, those of you that are joining me, what I like to say is use nice, light pencil lines so you can easily erase them. I like to use chalk often because chalk is easier to get rid of. If I make a mistake or if I want to change something, chalk. But pencil is okay too, just as long as you're making really nice light lines. So down here in the bottom corner somewhere, so this is the inside of my flower, the yellow part, what's eventually going to be the yellow part. In just a moment, I'm going to do an outline around it for this part right here, okay? But we're starting with that. Let me take a look at those comments, see what we got today. Paula, how's it going? Pearl and Alex, you can use paper, you can use whatever you got, okay? Let's see here. Jordan Asbury says, does anyone know where to get water-soluble pencils? So one thing you can do is you can get watercolor pencils. Here we go. Next line, next circle. So you can use watercolor pencils. Those work pretty well. You know what? Ideally, I recommend chalk. Chalk, you can put the chalk right onto your canvas, and if you want to erase it, take a little paper towel and you remove it, and it comes right off. Real easy to do. Okay? So chalk is my preference, but pencil's not a problem. As long as you're doing light pencil lines again, it's easy. If you make them really dark, then, of course, sometimes it's a little harder to remove. But, okay, let's go and take a look at our petals. So on my flower, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 petals. Okay? If you end up with 6 petals, if you end up with 4 petals, whatever it turns out like on your end is perfectly fine. Don't stress about creating the exact same version of what I've got over here. It's what I like to tell everyone. Everyone's creation ends up looking a little bit different. So what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to start with this flat, with this petal right in here. It's the petal that's right about in the middle. What we want to do is what I'll do is I'll come out here and I'll just put a little mark on my canvas. Maybe I'm going to make it a little bit larger so that you guys can see it a little bit better. But basically, that is about right in here. The reason why I put that mark down first is I want to make sure that I leave enough room for the little bee. Okay? But from right there, once I've got that mark, I'm just going to come out. Nice little curved lines. Now, some of these lines are going to overlap. When we make the flower or these petals, some of these lines are going to overlap. Okay, so we're just loosely drawing in our first petal. Don't stress too much, again, about how perfect it is. Once we start to add the paint to it, we can make modifications. But there's my first petal, and that's about this one right here. Okay? Once I've done that, I'll come over to the side, and maybe over here is the point of that petal. So from right here, and if it helps, you can also do this. You can draw a little line that goes all the way back to the center of your flower, just to kind of give you a gauge as to where that petal is. And then what you're going to do is you're simply going to do this. And again, you can overlap. Not a problem. Kind of like that. Nice and easy. Nothing to it. Let me lower the brightness on my light a little bit. I think might make it a little easier to see. There we go. Hold on one second. I'm going to go ahead and darken these in a little bit so you guys have a better view of what I've got on here. I'm looking at the video and I can see the a little bit on the light side. Again, though, you guys want to stick with really, really light pencil line. Okay? All right. So here we go. Third petal. We're going to go do this one over here. Now, again, same thing. I can just kind of make a little mark down here at the bottom to indicate where I want that point to be. And from there, I don't know about on your canvas, but I'm only going to be able to see part of the petal, right? I'm not seeing this part down here. Now, you might have enough room to include your entire petal, so if you do, go right ahead and put that in, okay? But there's that. All right. What's happening, guys? Amy Dusenberry, are you in Alaska? I think I remember, I know we've talked a few times, I believe you are in Alaska. Guadalupe, what's happening? How's it going? Jessica Kershaw, how are you? Paula Cooper, how's it going? And I don't know if somebody's talking about me, but I just want to, somebody's saying something about he lives in Alaska. I live in California. Okay, I'm out here in California. All right, here we go. Next petal, this one right here. Okay, again, just kind of come over here and do this. Make a little mark. Okay, bring that line all the way down just to give me a better visual. Okay, I know where that petal is going to connect. Once I've got that, I'm going to come over like this. Again, I overlap my lines a little. Okay, I want to leave a little space over here because I do have one more petal to add. Donna Fairchild from Muskogee, Oklahoma. Fantastic. Nancy Boyd Witherington from Florida. Thank you, Jessica. All right. Pretty basic. We got one more petal here, so just going to mark this one off. And just like the one over here, we can see part of the petal. But again, maybe on your flower, you can see the whole thing. It really depends on the size of canvas or paper that you're using. Modify it as you feel necessary. Okay, there's no right or wrong in this. We're just having some fun creating a little bit of art. This is a nice, simple painting. Okay. Yeah, just have fun. Feel free to make changes, modifications, etc. Those of you, if there's anyone that's new here on my page today, welcome. Welcome to the fun that we have here. But as I like to tell everyone, you're creating your own painting. I'm here to guide you along a little bit, helping you create something fun and neat. But if you feel like changing it up, making some changes to it, it is absolutely up to you. I like to see people's creativity. Okay? But all right, guys, here we go. Next little step. We're actually going to come in and draw. So we're not going to do any of those little circles in the center. We don't need them. We can add those with paint later. All these little lines in here, these little circles that are in there, we can add those once we start to add paint. Okay, these are one of the later steps that are involved in this whole process. But what we're going to do now is we're going to create this little bee. We're not going to add in the wings just yet. All we're going to do is create the center of our bee. And it's essentially almost like an oval shape. If you don't look at the little stinger down here, you've got almost an oval, an ovalish shape, or maybe more like an egg with the, an egg at the top is a little bit narrower than it is at the bottom. Maybe just imagine an upside down egg. Okay. So the top part of our little bee is a little wider, but it is pretty round. Come around in just a moment. I'll darken up my lines. Come around like this. Okay, something like this. Now, I'm not too worried about the stinger just yet, okay, because I'm going to paint around it. But I'm going to, just so you guys can see it, I'm going to go ahead and add it for now. But I'm going to paint over that more than likely when I come in with my blue.
I might paint over that and we'll add it in with black later. Just so you guys can see. Okay, there, that's where the stinger would go. And then of course we'd have the little antennae. I'm not adding those. I'm not adding the wings. The wings will come in later. Okay, but for now, just simply put in a little spot for your bee. And then we're gonna talk about our brushes here in just a moment. Okay? All right. You guys got about 1 minute, minute and a half, and we're gonna get moving here. Just gonna jump on my Facebook really quickly here while you guys are finishing up. I have to say hello to a school up in Alaska. Had a teacher reach out to me and say hello. I just wanted to reach out and say hi to that group. Give me a second while I look for. Here we go. Champlain Heights in Vancouver, British Columbia. Your teacher, Melissa, reached out to me, Miss Safari. If you guys are hanging out with us today, just want to say hello to your group. I really appreciate you guys being here. So Melissa asked if, you know, she basically said, hey, yeah, we really appreciate you doing these classes earlier in the day. It gives us a chance to jump on and join you. So just to kind of give you guys a heads up, I will be doing most of my classes typically start about 3 o'clock. Sometimes I'll do some at 2. Every once in a while, I'll do some at, sometimes I'll do some at 11, sometimes at 1, but most of my classes start a little bit later, about 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. I am going to be doing more classes earlier in the day. 1 o'clock is probably the earliest I'll be doing them during the week, but we'll see. So for those of you that do have, you know, maybe you have school, et cetera, you're a teacher, you want to incorporate some of these classes into your day, they are going to be available for you. Okay, so I can't make any promises with that. How many, et cetera, how many classes I'll be, you know, doing earlier, but I am going to be doing a lot more classes earlier in the day. Yeah, but anyway, hello to you all out there with the Champlain Heights School in Vancouver, British Columbia. Okay, I almost forgot the name. Actually, I did forget part of the name. So, but anyhow, welcome to all of you. Thank you for being here. But all right, let's take a look at our brushes. So I've got a big, large, I've got a 1-inch brush here. If you've got something similar, that's whatever you've got is okay. I've got this big 1-inch flat brush that I'll be using mainly to work in the background. I may use this brush to get some paint in here on the petals, okay? And then I've got 3 smaller brushes. Again, folks, don't stress too much about your brushes. You don't need anything exactly like what I've got. I've got a little, a smaller flat brush. I got a number 6 flat brush right here. These are 2 essentially the same brushes. This is a number 6 flat brush that I've got here. Okay, that I'll be using for some of the detail work in here. And then I've got a little skinny thing, little round one. This is a little number 0 round brush. Okay, that I'll be using for the outlining and things like that. Again, as long as you've got something similar, you're good to go. Don't stress about having the exact same brushes as I do. Let me go over the colors here really quickly. So I've got some light blue. Mostly I'm going to be using the light blue. I might mix it a little bit with my dark blue to create the background. And then I've got a little touch, a little bit of green, a little bit of black, brown, pink, yellow, and white. Okay, so whatever you've got, as long as it's kind of close to this, you're going to be okay. Give me a second. I'm going to grab an extra plate here so I can start mixing the background color, and then we're going to get right into it. All right, let's have some fun with a little bit of painting. I'm going to create the background color. Whatever background color you want to use is perfectly fine. I'm going to take a little bit of my light blue. Just going to grab some of this light blue. I'm going to bring it over to a severed plate that I've got here. Now, the paint's a little thick, so I'm going to have to add a little bit of water to it. But before I do that, I'm going to take a little bit of this dark blue, just a touch. I don't need a lot. Just want to darken up my background color a little bit. I'm going to mix that in here like this. There we go. I think that's a pretty good color. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my brush. Now, I've got some water in my cup. I just want to emphasize in between steps, if you're new to acrylic painting, you want your brushes to sit inside some water. sit in water so that they don't dry out on you. Acrylic paint dries very quickly. And if you let it dry out on your brushes, you might ruin the brushes, okay? So I recommend simply having some water in your water cup and letting those brushes sit in there in between steps. So again, I took a little bit of water. I'm going to do that again. I just dip my brush into the water cup and bring that water over to my paint. I mix it in really nicely. It helps the paint flow a little bit better. Now what I'm going to do is this. First thing I like to do whenever I draw first and I'm doing my background, I'll paint around the edges first. So I outline everything quickly. Then I'll come in and paint the rest of the background. I do my outlining first because it is easier to stay outside of the lines in this case. Okay, once I've got my background in place, I come in here and start doing, the outlining in place, I can come in here and then do the rest of the background. Now I can use nice long brush strokes like the ones I'm doing now. Nice long vertical brush strokes, and my background, it makes for a nice smooth background. I can also use horizontal brush strokes, okay, go left and right, or I can use little short choppy brush strokes like this. They just kind of go in different directions. Any one of these is perfectly fine. Doing these little choppy ones is kind of more fun, so I think that's what I'm going to stick with. What I do recommend, though, whatever you decide, you're going to do the same thing all the way around for your entire background. Okay, you don't want to do horizontal ones and then vertical ones and then short choppy ones in different areas. In other words, you want to stay uniform. It just makes for a better looking painting overall. But as I said earlier, whatever choices you want to make, that's perfectly fine. But I do recommend sticking to the same technique throughout. So in this case, I want to use these little short choppy lines. I know over here I did these long vertical ones. I'm just going to go through here and go over those lines again to make it all uniform and the same throughout. If you have extra thick paint, it depends on the paint brand that you got, or if your paint is a little older, sometimes it gets thick, right? Sorry, for a moment it looked like I lost the feed on my computer. I was like, uh-oh. If your paint sits for too long, or if it's been, you know, you've had it for a while, it can dry out a little bit. So it can get a little thick, hard to work with. Add a little bit of water to it on your plate, blend it in real nicely, and then it should make it easier to work with. I like to paint the sides of my canvases whenever I paint. I usually do this. So once I've done the front, I'm just going to go through here and paint the edges. In a moment, when I'm done with this part of it, I'm going to put my paints down for a bit, my brushes down for a bit. I'm going to say hello to a bunch of you guys in the comment section. Please let me know if it's your birthday. If you got a birthday, if you're celebrating a birthday anytime soon, or maybe today's your birthday. Any anniversaries, any first timers. If you're a first timer here, let me know. For those of you that have been painting with me for a while, you guys know how this works. Say hello. Let me know where you're painting from. Maybe let me know who you're painting with. All right, I know we've got people from all over the place. Lots of followers from different parts of the world on this page, and that's pretty dang awesome. But I'd love to see where you guys are joining me from. So as I mentioned earlier, when I went around my bee, like I said I would, I painted around the little stinger. Okay, I'll be adding that back in with black paint later. The reason why I painted over it is I didn't want to sit there bothering having to paint around it. Okay, so done with this brush, goes right back into my water cup. You guys got about a minute and a half, maybe 2 minutes to catch up. But let's see what you guys got for me. Let's see, Leslie, Crystal Ernest says, tomorrow is my birthday. Everybody say happy birthday to Leslie. Was that Leslie? I'm sorry. Yes, and she's from Vegas. What's happening in Vegas, Leslie? Happy birthday to you. Hope you're doing something fun besides painting with us today. I know that's fun. Let's see. Jessica Kershaw says, how many paintings have you ever done? I'm from Mississauga. I can't quite read it. Mississauga is what it looks like. It's really small over here, and I don't have my glasses on, so can't see every single part of it. Oh, I don't know, Jessica. A few hundred, maybe 1,000, never a couple thousand. I don't even know now, to be honest. Lots of them. But as far as paintings on this page, we've probably done, we're closing in on 80 now, and all of the videos are currently available for you to go back and watch them. If you guys are new to the page and are interested in checking out all the other videos that we've done here, we started painting live sessions, doing live sessions here on Facebook back in March of last year was the first one. So since then, we've probably done about 80, and I just recently started broadcasting to both Facebook and to YouTube. If you guys are interested in checking out all the past videos on Facebook, under the live tab on the main page here, under Painting with Jesse, you click on the live tab and you'll see all of the old videos. Lots of fun stuff there for all ages. Okay, lots of children or kid-centric events and lots of events geared towards an older audience. Okay, but you guys can go check those out. Amelia Jeggles Smith says it's my son's birthday, March. Oh, my son's birthday is March 8th. Happy early birthday to Aiden, who's going to be 8 years old. Let's see. All right, guys. In a little bit, I'll give you guys a close-up of the paintings that are coming up. Okay? You guys, actually, let me grab a couple of those right now when you guys are finishing up with this part of it. We're almost ready to move on. We're going to start painting. We're actually going to do a layer of yellow on our little bee. Okay? So in just a moment, we're going to do that. Give me a sec. Now, again, these are just some of the paintings that are coming up on this page. We got a whole bunch in March. We got one more painting event left in February. That's this Wednesday. And I'll try to bring up the Blue Jay painting that we're going to be doing. But on St. Patrick's Day, we're going to be painting this little guy right here. I'm going to be teaching you guys how to draw this completely from scratch. And then we're going to paint it. I will be providing a stencil for those of you who would like to use one. If you guys go over, check out under the event tab. Here on the Painting with Jesse page, you'll see all the details, okay? Then that same week, later in the week, this is the way for all of you Mandalorian fans out there. Again, teaching you guys completely everything from scratch, okay? If you guys join me when we did little Grogu here, little baby Yoda, about a month and a half ago, that was a really fun event. Anyway, this is the follow-up to that. I will be providing a stencil for that. So, again, go over to the event tab, check out the details, and then come join us. All right? This is a few days, two, 3 days after March 17th. So this might be on the Friday following St. Patrick's Day. Okay? So just a couple of the events coming up. A lot more. I'll share some more paintings with you in a little bit. But here we go. Let's talk about our little bee. Okay? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take one of my smaller brushes, my little number 6 flat brush here. Okay, it's a little, got a little skinny brush, a little square head. Just going to grab a little bit of yellow right from my palette. Don't need to mix it with anything. And I'm just going to come in here and I'm going to paint the inside of our little bee. Now, if you painted your entire background blue and then are adding in your little bee here after the fact and you're painting over blue, your little bee might look green because it's going to blend in with the background color. Okay, but if that was the case, let's say you painted your entire background at or adding the bee later or adding the bee now, it's going to look a little green if you're painting over blue. Okay, you're going to need to layer it so that it gets really nice and bright yellow like this one. Okay, so take a moment with that. You guys got about 30 seconds because this should be pretty basic, right? Nothing too fancy here. Now, I'm going to go back to my big brush. Okay, going back to this guy right here. I'm going, depending on the color of your flower, and I could change it up. Maybe if I wanted to, I could make a mostly pink flower or a mostly yellow flower, right? I could change a red flower if I wanted to. If I had red on here, I wanted to make it red, I could do that. But I'm going to take a little bit more of this yellow first, And I'm just going to come in here. You guys, I have a little bit of green, a little bit of blue on my brush. Didn't clean it up well enough. So it's blending in with my yellow, making some of this a little bit green, but that's okay. I'm not too worried about it. Simply going to put in a layer of yellow at the same time. Usually whenever I am doing a painting, if I'm using the same color throughout, let's say I've got a bunch of areas where I'm using yellow, I try to do those all at the same time. Okay, it's a little bit more efficient of a way to paint. So now that I've used my yellow here, I'm going to clean up my brush with my paper towel. Okay. Now I'm going to grab a little bit of this blue. Again, I'm going to bring it over to my mix plate right here where I've got some of this light blue still. Just going to mix the two colors a little bit. Now, when I mix these, I don't make them perfectly blended where it's all one even color. I want to see a little bit of both colors coming through. Okay, a little bit of blue, a little bit of light blue. Okay, so it's kind of a swirly color. Once I've done that, I'm going to start right in here. I'm using the edge of my brush, skinny part of my brush here, my big, large 1-inch brush, just coming through here. Now here I can kind of do here at the bottom, I can kind of brush like this to get the paint on there. But then I'm going to go ahead and do this. Long brush strokes. Okay. And I move on to the next one. This is kind of my base color. I will be adding some pinks and some greens in there. Who knows? Maybe I'll change it up a little and add a few other colors. We'll see. Using long brush strokes with the skinny part of my brush. You could use the broadside if you want it also. But these long, skinny brush strokes give me these thin lines on the inside that I like. Okay, and we're just going to continue doing all of the petals. Now it's up to you. You see how I'm kind of overlapping my colors? Whichever petals you want to stand out, you overlap that petal over the others. Okay, and there's no right or wrong with that. I'll show you guys here in a moment what I'm talking about once I've painted all the petals. I want to make sure I get all these little areas down here at the bottom. So here around where the brown part is, I'm coming through here and kind of doing that first. Okay. Or you can do it like that to clean up your edge. So here we go. Let's continue. Whoops. So again, as I overlap any of my petals, so what I did here is I overlapped this petal with this one here. Now this petal is in the forefront. Okay? In the foreground. Before I started, it was kind of touch and go because I wasn't sure that I was going to be able to solve my audio issue. And it kind of was like pushing it. And then within like the last 5 minutes, I said, I'm going to have to do this with one camera. Actually, it was more like within the last 2 minutes. I'm going to have to do this with one camera. And how do I do my one camera setup? Luckily, it wasn't that crazy or difficult to do. But anyway, I have to resolve that because that's a bummer. I like my new setup. Either way, here we are having some fun. But all right, this last petal. Now watch this. This is what I was talking about with the overlapping of the petals. So once I'm done doing the first layer of paint all the way around, I can look at my flower and I can say, okay, are there any petals that I want to stand out or be in the foreground as opposed to any other flower. any other petals. So maybe I want this petal to be in the foreground, right? So I can do this. I can take the edges of this petal and I'll go like this. I'll overlap the ones next to it. And it's kind of subtle, but it does make a difference. So pick the petals that you want to stick out, to stand out a little bit more, and then use your brush to overlap. So paint your edges of that one over the edges of the others. Okay, so if you notice, this petal here overlaps that petal. Same with this one. This one's in the front, that one's in the back. This one's in the back, that one's in the front. Okay, but you can do it whichever way you'd like. I think that's kind of a neat little pattern where this one's in the front, back, front, right? If you kind of start from here, you go, this one's in the front, that one's behind it. Front, behind it, front, okay? Doesn't have to be done that way. Just an idea. Okay. You guys got about 2 minutes to get done with that, and then we're moving on. All right, so who do we have in the comments section? Let's see. Yep, and don't forget, folks, if you cannot finish with me today or you weren't able to join us for whatever reason, this video is going to be available after the live session. Live session is done. You'll find it under the live tab on the main Painting with Jesse page, okay? And it'll also be on YouTube, on my YouTube. So if you're behind, if you can't keep up, don't stress out. Do the best you can. Try to keep up. But if you do fall behind, as soon as this is over, you can simply go over to the live tab on the main page or on YouTube, and you'll find the video there, and you can just continue with the recorded session, okay? So again, don't stress out. What's up, Pamage? Sounds good. Yep, you know how this works. You can come on back and paint it later. What's happening, Hannah? How are you? Susan, Power, don't we're asking, how's it going? Hi, Susan, Roro. Roro says, I just finished my meeting and joined in late. I will paint later. Cool. So yes, Penny Carroll, you will be able to watch this later. Okay, I just want to make sure everybody understands that. You will have a chance as soon as it's over. As soon as our live session is over, I hit save. And this video lives up in that live tab. Okay, so again, wherever you are when we're done here, when I say, hey, this is over, we're done, and I say goodbye to everyone, you'll simply go over to that live tab. See the video right there. It'll be waiting for you to come back and join in with, okay? So, all right, everyone. So, we're going to be moving over for a little bit. I'm going to take one of my small brushes, okay, back to my little flat brush. Okay, I'm going to take a little bit of this brown. Now, my brown's a little dark in comparison to the original. No big deal. I could use this color if I want. Or I can take a little bit of yellow to lighten it up just a bit, just my preference. Okay, there's no right or wrong here. You can use whatever colors you'd like, but I'm gonna lighten up this brown a bit. Okay, and again, I can leave it a little bit swirly. It doesn't have to be perfectly blended all one color. Then I'm going to take this, and I'm just gonna come in here in between my blue and my yellow, and I'm going to add a little layer of brown. So this painting today is a much simpler version. I should say a much simpler painting in comparison to some of the ones we've done over the past few months. A lot of the stuff we do on here, even for beginners, you know, even our the ones that I... My events are open to all levels of experience, but this is a little bit more of a beginner's type of painting, I would say. You can learn a little bit about how paint works. It's not super complex, not overwhelming. Okay, so this is perfect. If you're new to painting, this is a perfect one to jump in on. So here around the edges, I'm just going to kind of overlap my brown a little bit, just kind of go beyond and into the blue area just a little bit, okay? And then maybe around my edges, I'll just kind of bring them in just a touch into the yellow, okay? Just like that. Okay, so about a minute, minute and a half. And we will move on. All right, folks, who else we got? Smoggy Sammy, how's it going from YouTube? How are you? Champlain Heights. All right. Sammy, how are you? Thank you for joining in today. You're on YouTube. I know we don't have a lot of YouTube folks on today. It looks like it's about seven folks on YouTube hanging out with us. To all of you on that platform, hello. Hello to you guys. Thank you for being here. Now, my YouTube channel has been slowly growing over the past month or so. So I really appreciate those of you that are on there. If you have a YouTube channel and you're joining me on Facebook, for those of you, I know sometimes some people prefer to do this on YouTube. Just know that I am doing all these videos. They're going to be simultaneously broadcast to both platforms. Okay? Carol Ann, yeah, don't worry if you're behind. Again, folks, don't stress out about it. Okay, I don't want you guys stressing. Just have a good time. Have a good time with this, and just there's really no even if you're halfway through, maybe you're halfway to where I am right now. It's all good. You're not. This painting is simple enough where you can be completely behind, and you'll be okay when we're done. Again, just simply go over to the live to the recorded session. Justin Kershaw says hi. Your artwork is super super nice and cool. When are you doing the Grogu? So this guy right here, we're going to be doing on, I believe it's Friday after St. Patrick's Day. So that would be the 19th of March. Okay. And again, I'll be teaching you how to draw and how to paint this completely from scratch. But I am making a stencil available for those that would like one. They are free. I will have it on the event tab for this event, on the event page for this. It'll be there under the discussion tab. Okay. So just be aware that you will be able to use a stencil. Sorry, folks, I'm being distracted with my internet, checking out my internet. Looks like it's a little bit sketchy right now. But okay, let's continue here. Next step. What I'm going to do now, one of my small brushes, just going to clean it up a little bit. You got it, Jessica. You're just going to clean it up a little, get that brown out of there, swirling around my cup. Now I'm going to take paper towel, I'm going to clean it a little. Now this is where I'm going to come in with the different colors. So watch what I do here. I grab some paint, and using this brush, I'm going to press it down on my plate. What that does is when I press it down, it makes the tip of the bristles, it bunches them together, makes them nice and thin. So what I can do with this dark color and come in here and just start adding little streaks. These are kind of random. Some are going to be shorter, some are longer. Okay, just like that. And I'm going to do that to all of my petals. Now again, whichever petal's in the front, when you get to the edges, you want those. You want to do the edges of whichever petals you want in the front. So, for example, when I do this petal here, I do the edges on the edges for it. When I do this one here, I do not do the edges. Okay. When you guys finish today, especially those of you that are new, I like to check out your masterpieces. You guys can take pictures of your work, maybe take a picture of yourselves holding your paintings, and send them to me on Painting with Jesse here on Facebook. If you guys are on YouTube, you guys can email them to me, paintingwithjesse@gmail.com. I love to see your work, and then I like to share your pictures with everyone. So once I get everyone's paintings, maybe tomorrow sometime, I'll do a large post where I say, hey guys, check it out. Check out all the pictures that everyone shared with me. And you guys can go and check them out and see what everyone did. It's a lot of fun to see everyone's different choices. Okay, so there's that for now. Take a few moments on that. In just a little bit, I'm going to switch it up and do some in green, and then I'm going to do some in pink. Again, when I'm done with the brush, it sits right inside my water cup. Okay. All right. What's happening, Jessica Gray from Maine. Marsha Hibison, first timer from Texas. Hi, Marsha. I hope you're doing well out there in Texas. I know you guys are, some of you are having a hard time with the weather. So hopefully everything is good out there and you know everybody's okay. Hope you're in a nice, warm place. But thank you for being here. What's happening, Matthias from Canada? What's happening? Much love to you, too. Thank you for being here. Yeah, you can. So, Paula, when you send me your pictures, guys, send them through my messenger on Painting with Jesse. Now, I like to keep them all in the same place, right? If I can receive them all in the same place, or instead of having them all over the place so I don't have to go track them down, it's easier if you guys send them to me on Messenger if you're on Facebook. Messenger on Painting with Jesse, or paintingwithjesse@gmail.com if you're on YouTube. Okay, and then I group them all together. But yeah, whichever way you'd like to, that'd be perfectly fine. What's happening, Gina from Syracuse? And then let's see. Who else do we got here? Patty Hyatt. How's it going, Patty? Alexandra, yes, Red Solo Cup. I know. Red Solo Cup gang right here. All right, guys, here we go. Let's continue. So I'm using the same brush, okay? And I'm just going to use my paper towel to squeeze out any extra paint. Okay, it doesn't really matter too much in this case. I'm working on the inside of the flowers so the colors can mix a little bit. But I'm going to take a little bit of my green here. Okay, and again, don't forget, press down on your brush. Make sure that that tip gets nice and skinny. And then I'm just going to come in here, and I'm just going to add a few of these little lines. And add them wherever you want, as many as you want. You're just going to have more green, less green, no green, all up to you. Maybe you have a different color. Maybe you're using orange in yours or red or whatever. It's up to you, right? Just have fun with it. Okay. And I do want to invite all of you that are new. If you haven't yet, please follow the page, both Facebook and YouTube. So the only way you're going to get notifications when I post all of the events. Now, on YouTube, I have to figure out a way. It's going to have to be a video of some sort where I post the upcoming events so you guys can see what we've got going on, right? The calendar. I think on the main page, I can post a calendar. But if you're on Facebook, every time I post a new event, you'll get a notification if you follow the page. Got lots of events coming up in March, so make sure you guys do follow the page so you get that information. I showed you some of them at the beginning, but there's a lot more than that. In March, I'm going to be doing at least, let me see, 1, 2, 3. I'm thinking I'm probably going to be doing at least 10 events in March, at least 10 events. Okay, so if you guys are following the page, be ready to have some fun. Okay, so there's my green. I'm quickly going to go ahead and grab some pink. After I do the pink, I'm going to give you guys a little time to catch up. Now, there's a little bit of a difference that I did with this pink color, a little different. I used this on the tips primarily, on the tips and on the bottom, on the ends of the petals. Okay, so up to you again, however you'd like to do it, but what I did was this. Now watch, all this is dry right here. I can use my pinky to help stabilize my finger, my hand, right? Especially if your hand shakes a little. Some people's hands shake a little bit more than others. This can be a little difficult to do if you're just free floating your hand. If you're doing this, it can be a little tricky, especially if you're newer and you haven't gotten the hang of making your hand, more stable. With time, you can practice and your hand won't be as shaky. But use your pinky. You place it up against the canvas. It can stabilize your hand a bit. So your brush strokes are a little bit smoother. So again, I'm doing it here on the tips of the petals, and then I'll come down here at the base. And I'll do the same thing. What's cool about it is I know some of you guys are going to be doing mostly pink flowers. Some of you are going to be doing orange flowers, red flowers. So I'm looking forward to seeing all of your different choices. Part of the fun for me. Okay, something like that. And if you want to add a few little pink ones down in the inside somewhere, you can. I think I like the pink on my petals here towards the edges. Kind of like that look. So I'm going to leave them like that. Okay. All right. You guys got about 2 minutes. Let me give you a close up here of what I've got so far. Okay. Nothing too fancy, nothing too crazy. Just a nice, simple little flower and bee painting. What's happening, Penny Colt? How are you? Thank you for being here. Let's see. Who else we got on right now? Did I miss any birthdays? Let me show you guys. So, I'll give you guys a close-up of some of the paintings I showed at the beginning. So, on Tuesday, March 2nd, for those of you that don't know, and I didn't know, I found out, we got Tuesday, March 2nd is Dr. Seuss's birthday. And I'm going to be teaching you guys on that day how to draw from scratch, how to paint the Cat in the Hat. Okay, I will be providing a stencil for those of you who would like to use them, probably a stencil for his face, maybe the hat, who knows. The event is already up. If you guys go over to that event tab, you guys will find the details for this event. All my live events are free. Okay, so for those of you that don't know, I don't charge for the events, but I do accept support through my tip jar. I have a virtual tip jar that you guys can use. It's in the description of the video, but let me see here. For those of you that are interested, I do have, let me see, there we go. There's the information on the screen right now. I do have a Venmo under Painting with Jesse, all one word, at Painting with Jesse. I have a PayPal, same thing. The name on the PayPal would be actually both Venmo and PayPal, Painting with Jesse. And then I do have a Zelle, 951-217-2237. I've had a few people from Canada inquire about a virtual tip jar that's easier for them to use. And I'm in the process of setting one up. Okay, some of you have sent me donations through, I'm trying to remember what the method is called. And I can't access those. So I'm working on something. But anyway, if you guys are interested, that is my virtual tip jar information. And again, it's also under the description of the video. Okay? Greatly appreciated. Also, for those of you that can, if you can share the page, once you've painted, done your masterpiece, and you share your masterpiece on your social media, if you guys could tag the page, that would be fantastic. Okay? All right. Let me get back to you guys' comments. Oh, don't need that folder. Let's see. Oh, here we go. Back to the comments. Okay. Here we go, guys. Jessica Kershaw says, what was the longest painting you've ever done? I mean, by time. Wow. So I've done portraits before I started doing these live sessions and stuff, actually a few years back, 6 years ago, I was doing lots of commission work, portraits, figurative work, some of them really large pieces, 4 or 5 feet tall. And those can take 30, 40, 50 hours to paint, sometimes longer. So it really depends. But yeah, I think the longest was probably about 40, 50 hours. Not all at one sitting, of course, but yeah, some paintings can take a long time. Patience is definitely required. Okay. But all right, folks, here we go. Let's continue. What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to use this little round brush, a little skinny pointy thing. Okay, this is what you call a round. This is a number 0 brush. I'm going to take some black. Okay, straight black right from the plate. Now, if it's a little bit, if it's a little thick on your, if your paint is a little thick, make sure you grab a little bit of water, take your brush, dip it right into that water cup, take a little bit of water out, and then mix it in with the paint. Okay, so a little bit of water, mix it in with the paint. It helps the paint flow a lot better. So I just added a touch of paint to mine. What I'm going to do, I'm sorry, touch of water to mine. I'm going to come on over to my bee. I'm going to add, so I'm trying to do this without blocking it, blocking the painting with my hand. So right here at the bottom, I'm just going to do a little section. See, I can reposition my stool here. And then I'm going to go ahead and add the little stinger. My little busy bee has a nice little long stinger. Careful you don't add too much water to the paint, as I did. If you add too much water, simply take more paint and mix it in with your mixture to thicken it up just a little bit. Okay, so there's my little stinger. My little busy bee just picked up some bee pollen and is headed back to the beehive. Okay, so there's, I'm going to go ahead and do little stripes also. Little stripe here. Your little busy bee has four stripes. Mine has a little stripe here at the bottom that connects to the stinger. Then it's got another stripe above it. But if yours has four stripes, five stripes, it's all good. All this is dry, so I can put my finger on it, my hand on it. Now I'm putting my palm right over the painting. Okay? As long as I don't put my palm wherever there's wet paint, we are good. So there's the first stripe on my bee. Next stripe. So one thing with these little skinny brushes, once I've got the paint, my brush in the paint, what I like to do is I'll spin the brush as I pull it away. I press down, spin, and pull, and that makes the point smaller, skinnier, easier to work with. There's my next stripe. So what do you guys think will be the trickiest part on this painting for most of you? Okay, there's a part on here that's going to be the trickiest for most of you, Not everyone. I don't want anybody freaking out about it. But when we make the little antennae, on top of our little bee's head, could be a little tricky for some of you. Okay. So work on your little stripes for a moment. Pearl and Alex, bye-bye. Thank you for joining in. Hello, Shanton Azam. How's it going? Okay, Gina, sounds good. Blending in the pink and the green. There you go. Sounds good. Sarah Lee, it is my pleasure. Thank you guys for being here. My favorite painting, Susan Howard Domorowski asks me what my favorite painting is. So I have this painting of this couple dancing. Some of you may have seen it on some of my earlier videos. It's in the back. I used to have it on the background wall when I had my studio in my house. But there's a picture. It's a mostly black and white picture with a couple dancing. It looks like they're dancing a tango or you know, something, where they're really nice and up close. And the lady has a red dress. Really beautiful red dress. My favorite color to paint in is called alizarin crimson. It's this really deep, vibrant red that I painted the dress in on that one. That one there is my favorite. Yeah, I have lots of favorites, but that one is my personal favorite. But one of these days I'm going to be doing a tutorial on that one. I'll be doing a tutorial on that piece. It's gotten a lot of people asking me when they used to see it on the background, on my background wall. People used to ask me all the time. So at some point I'll be doing a tutorial, simplified version. It's a large piece. It's about, I think it's about 4 feet tall, 2 inches, 2 feet wide. So it's pretty tall, but I'll be making a simplified version of that. I did that in oil paint also. Oil paint is different, right? A little different to work with. But all right, let's continue with our little bee. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to do the little antennae. Okay, right over the top of the head. Okay, of course, skinny little line curls. I'll start with a little skinny line. Now you can start from over here. What I like to do is this. I'm going to do a little dot and a little dot. Those little dots are about where the little round parts of the antenna are going to be. But from there, I'm going to work my way back to the top of my little bee's head. Okay? Little skinny. So little skinny lines are tricky. You want to use the very tip of your bristles. Okay? Very tip of the bristles. And again, if you take your brush and spin it in the paint as you pull it away, it makes the tip a little smaller, a little skinnier. It makes it a little easier to do this. It's also, you know, a good idea to put your hand on your canvas. Again, as long as it's nice and dry, you can place your hand right on the canvas, your palm, and it stabilizes your hand. Yeah, there we go. And now, whoops, I think I was off screen when I did that. Okay, but once I've done that, I can come in here and okay. Give my little antennas a couple little ovalish shaped ends. Okay, something like that. Once we've done that, I'm going to give my little bee a couple little eyes, just little dots. Okay. Just like that. Nothing fancy. Give you guys a little time to catch up. Well, the Nupa says beautiful. And she has a little icon of B and beautiful. What's happening, Regina May Velasquez? The biggest painting that I've done, I believe, was a 5 foot by 6 foot canvas. I did this really cool commission piece for a law firm out towards Orange County here in California. It was a giant. They were superhero fans, Marvel comic fans. They commissioned me to do like a mosaic of all these Marvel superheroes, the Avengers, parts of the Avengers' faces. It was a really cool piece. One day I'll show you guys. How's it going, Colin? Welcome. Hello, Mikey. How's it going, Sammy's nephew, Mikey? How are you? Yeah, guys, please, if you guys want me to give you guys a shout-out, tell me in the comments, and I will say hello to you, okay, as long as I see your comment. It's kind of a smaller group today, so it gives me an opportunity to see everybody's comments. When we have a really large group, it makes it a lot more difficult for me to keep up with the comment section. But, okay. But, yeah, if you guys want me to say hello to you, put it down in the comments and I'll give you a shout out. What's happening, Rhonda? Joe West Evans from Jackson, Tennessee. How's it going out in Tennessee? Hopefully you're having a fantastic day. Thank you for being here. But all right, folks, here we go. Next little step. So we're working with black right now. And as I mentioned earlier, what I like to do is anytime we're using a color that is in different parts of our paintings, I like to go ahead and jump around a little bit using that same color throughout. So we have these little black sections in here, these little round circles. They're really light. I'm painting on an easel, right? And I've got my table here. What I like to do is I'll put my hand on the table and then I'll put my painting hand over my wrist of the non-painting hand like this, and it stabilizes my hand. So I can kind of do that too. That's another technique. So my hand goes right on the table, right over that goes my other hand. And what I'm going to do is right here in this little brown section, I'm just gonna add a few little circles. Partial circles, complete circles, I'm gonna do this all the way around. Some circles a little more visible than others, right? Small, partial, bigger ones. And again, I'm just using the very point of our bristles here. Okay, all the way around, kind of like that. What's happening, Lynn Frost Hutchins from Nova Scotia, Canada? How are you? The smallest painting I've ever done. Ooh, that's a really good question. Smallest painting. Oh, I know. One time I took a tree branch. Little tree branch. Not that little. Probably about this thick. We cut it into little sections. So I had these round pieces, and then we sanded down the sides, and on there, on those little pieces of wood, we painted little mountain scenes, and like sunsets and water and things like that. Pretty neat little paintings that we did. They're probably about this big. I think it's the smallest one I've ever done, off the top of my head. All right. Paula Cooper says, can you give a shout out to my granddaughter, Katie? How's it going, Katie? Thank you for being here, Katie. Oh, Erica, yes. I don't know if she might be on here right now, Mila. I'll tell her. I'll definitely tell her. She might be on here from home. I'm over here at the studio, but she might be on here helping to kind of watch the comments for scammers. So Alicia Rainey says, hi from Kansas, first time painting with you. Fantastic, Alicia. Thank you. Alicia or Alicia, I'm not sure which way to pronounce that, but thank you for being here. I really appreciate it. That goes for all of you. Thank you so much. All right, next step, folks. I'm switching back to one of my, now I have two of these, little six, number sixes. Oh, sorry, not that one. I want that one. Back to this one right here, number six, little flat brush. Now, all my brushes are synthetic bristle brushes. For those of you that are newer to painting, maybe you're interested in getting yourselves some brushes, but they're all synthetic bristle brushes. I'm going to take some of this light blue and bring it over to my mix plate. I'm going to take a little bit of white paint. I'm just going to mix the two together, creating a lighter blue. You guys can probably already guess where I'm going to use this. On the original there, I used this for my little wings on the bee. Now, if your bee's really small, you're going to want to just be careful. Make sure you're using a small brush. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in here. Now, I'm going to try to use just the corner of my brush here. There's a little corner right in there. And I'm going to do this. Okay. Rounded wing. Okay. Then other wing. A little smaller than the one on top. Okay. So we'll do that with the other one as well, the other side. I can also use my little round brush for this. Just pick a little small brush and make a couple of wings on your beak. You can also do this in pencil first if you want, and then fill them in. Okay? Don't forget, when you're done, brushes go back into your water cup. Debbie Germano from Oregon, don't worry, the recorded session is available immediately after, okay? So don't stress out. If you missed it, you'll be able to catch the recorded session. Let's see. Who else, guys? I'm looking over the comment section now. You guys can see over to the left of the screen over here. You can see where I'm monitoring the feed on my laptop. Okay, here we go. Next step. I'm going to take a little bit of black. Okay, and what I'm going to do now is I will come in here and outline the wings. That's what makes them stand out. Okay, like that. Okay. Now, this bee here is a little bit bigger than that one. Okay, I'm good with it. Again, everybody's drawings, everybody's painting. Turns out a little different. That's perfectly all right. The point is not to necessarily recreate the exact same painting that I've got, but rather a version of your own. Maybe similar to mine, but what you'll find typically is that everyone has a slightly different and unique painting, and that's really, really cool. So if yours isn't looking just like mine, don't worry about it. Okay, it's all right. Once I've outlined the wings, I am going to outline the top of the head. Makes our little bee stand out a little bit more against the background. Then I'm going to go ahead and maybe refine the stinger a little bit, maybe make it a little bit longer. Like that. There's a little close up right there. All right, a couple things left. Well, let me make sure I take a good look around. I like to forget things in my paintings. Whenever I do these lessons, almost every single, we're not done yet, but I'm just saying, I always need to take a look around, a careful look around, because I like to forget stuff. What I'm going to do now, using the same small brush, I cleaned it up a little bit in my water cup. Just going to dip it right into this brown. Okay, what I'm going to do next is this. Kind of same thing that we did out here, I'm going to do on the inside here. It's going to take some of these little, my brush, and do these little brown circles. Now I can lighten them up. On this one, they're a little bit lighter because I dipped my paint in some, I mixed yellow with brown. But you don't have to. Whatever color you've got. Maybe you're not even using brown. Maybe you're just going through here with a completely different color. So anyway, we're going to make these little swirls. little center of our flower. So I'm using my hand here. I put it on my table. You guys can't see it because it's a little lower than the camera can see, than the camera view. But my hand here sits here on the table right below, putting my other hand on top. So when I do this, nice and easy, stabilized hand. Again, I can do this because I'm painting on an easel, right? Maybe some of you guys are painting on a table. So this isn't necessarily something you can do, but lots of little tricks to painting. Okay? So take a few moments to do that. We are getting close to the end of our session today. So, what else are we painting on this page? Well, let's see here. I don't remember the date on this one. I'll show you here in a second. But first week of March, I believe it's the weekend of March. This little spring Easter bunny. Now, this one's quite a bit more complex than what we got going on today, right? This one's a little bit more detailed. This one's definitely going to take us close to 3 hours to do. Okay. But the event is already up. If you go over to the event page on the Painting with Jesse page, I will have stencils available for the rabbit and for the pot. But I will be drawing this completely by hand. You guys will be drawing it with me for those of you who want to learn how to draw. Okay, but that's part of the reason why these take so long. We draw everything from scratch and we paint. Okay, so again, first week of March, for those of you that are interested, a little early spring Easter piece. Hi, Emma. 5-year-old Emma today. Let's see, it's painting along today. Hi, Emma. Thank you for being here. What's up? What's happening, Aricia? Thank you for being here. Welcome back, I should say. Let's see. And then, now again, folks, I just want to emphasize, there's a lot more paintings than these coming in March. These are just a few of them. This one, I just posted the event earlier today. For those of you who joined me on the Valentine's gnome piece last month, check this one out. Look at this. The St. Patrick's gnomies right here. Okay. I'll be making stencils available for this, but we're also going to be doing this one completely from scratch. Okay. So that one, the date. This one is, I don't remember. Might also be the first week of March. First week of March is pretty packed. Got all kinds of stuff going on. But anyway, March is going to be an especially fun month, I think. Okay? So for those of you that are interested, make sure you guys come back and join me. Mandy, that was by accident. Let's see, Mandy says, Jesse, you keep saying thank you for being here, and it's making me giggle. I would love a shout out, Grumpy, today. Feeling better now. We are lucky to have you. Thank you, Mandy. Thank you so much. And I believe you sent me a message yesterday, Mandy. I will reply to you. You sent me a message. And I haven't, it's just been such a crazy last, it's just always busy over here. So anyway, I will reply to you. But thank you so much. Yeah, but thank you all for being here. That's hilarious. I say that all the time, but today I think it's especially appropriate. But all right, everyone, here, let's continue with our little bee painting, little busy bee painting. I'm going to grab my little flat brush, my little number 6, just cleaning it up a little. Okay, just going to swirl it around my cup. I'm going to grab my paper towel. I do want to remove as much paint as I can. Just going to dip it right into the paint here. Grabbing some, a little bit of this yellow. And I'm just going to come in here on some of these little sections, not all of them, but in the center here of my flower. Just going to take some of this yellow and it's kind of a thick layer that I'm putting on. And again, not every single part of the of my flower is going to have some of this, but just being a little selective. Just scooping some of this up, and I'm just coming over. and going like that. I know it's a little hard for you to see, but just layering this paint on a little thick, giving the center of my flower a little bit of a 3D effect. Just a little bit, nothing too obvious. Okay, so don't worry about that too much. But then the very last thing, I'm saying last thing right now simply because I believe this is going to be the last step, but I'm going to take a little step back and look at it before we're all done, making sure I'm not forgetting anything. I'm going to take my little round brush here. I'm going to grab some paint. And again, I spin the tip of my brush so that the bristles get really narrow. And then, of course, we got the little path that my bee took from the flower. I'll start it right here, little dash lines. My little bee took a little circle path as it was leaving. As I was leaving the flower. So it's just little dash lines, okay? And you could layer these to make them stand out a little bit more. Once this dries a little, I can come back and do another layer over the top, and those will be a lot more prominent. Okay? So there's that. Take a little moment on that. Let me see if I can find the Blue Jay painting. Give me 1 second. Unless I took it home, it should be here in my studio. Right under my nose. Okay, so this Wednesday, this is a lot more complicated than the one today, but do not fret. I'm providing, for those of you who don't know, I do provide stencils for the birds. Go to the event page. You're going to find that under the discussion board. Okay, just go down to the discussion board. You can download them from there. Okay, but I'm going to be teaching you how to draw this from scratch. There's not a whole lot going on in the background, okay, because we're focusing primarily on drawing and painting these birds. But, that's this coming Wednesday. If you guys are interested, go check out those details on that event tab, and you guys will find out what you need. Okay, it's all acrylic paint. A few people have asked me if that's done in watercolor, but no, it's acrylic paint. Just a little bit watered down, so it gives a little bit of a watercolor effect. Yeah, just a little bit. But all right. So I didn't do the bottom edge. Okay. I can do that now if I'd like. I would flip it over, paint that. Not going to do it at the moment. We'll do that a little bit later. I'll do that on my own later. But what I always tell people is you want to make sure you sign your masterpieces. I'm going to take a little bit of green here. And I noticed I didn't sign my original. But I'm going to sign my piece over here somewhere. Find a little spot. Most artists will sign their paintings towards the bottom, but you can sign it wherever you want. Corner, side, back, even, up to you. Okay, but I just signed my piece right there. Okay. Then don't forget, folks, please do send me a copy of your painting. If you're under 18, if you're underage, you need to get permission from your parents first. Okay, please don't send me anything. Actually, let your parents send me the pictures. You can't send me anything. And if you're painting with a group, please take a picture of your group holding your paintings, send them on over so that I can share them with everyone. Okay, I'll make a post. Like I said, it's usually the following day, but once I get a bunch of paintings, I'll put them all together on one large post and everyone can see what everyone did. Okay, get to see everyone's creativity. But I put up my virtual tip jar information on the screen again for those that are interested. Again, this information is also listed under the description of the video. We are pretty much done today. Today was a nice little short piece. Haven't had a painting this short in quite a while. But I hope you guys all enjoyed it. I know I did, as I always do. Thank you guys all. I really appreciate you guys hanging out. Give me a second. Let me get back to your comments. There we go. You got it, Lynn. Thank you for being here. Penny, going to be here for the birds, huh? Fantastic. And I know I'm missing a few other announcements. My memory doesn't work so well, especially when you're asking me about dates and stuff. But if you guys are interested in checking out what's coming, just go over to the event tab here on the Painting with Jesse page, and you'll see all the details there. Again, if you're new here and you haven't yet, please follow the page so that you can get notifications whenever I post new stuff. My calendar is being updated pretty regularly. I don't have all of the events up for March yet, so just be on the lookout, because I'm adding more events this week, okay? Again, I'm updating the calendar for March. Currently, I think I've got like, I don't know, 5-6 events already scheduled for March, but I'm going to have at least 10, but looking to possibly do more like 12 or 13 if I can. I can throw those in, okay? But anyhow, I will talk to all of you very soon. If you guys have any questions or comments, You guys can reach me on Messenger here at Painting with Jesse. Again, that's where I want you guys to send your paintings to me, or you can also email them to me at paintingwithjesse@gmail.com. Okay? Christine, my pleasure. Thank you for being here. Hopefully your day is much better. Okay? And for all of you that are out in the really cold areas like Texas and some of the areas nearby, other states nearby, please stay safe. Our thoughts are with you, and I know it looks like things are getting a little bit better, so hopefully that's the end of that, and everything turns out okay. Okay, once again, everyone, thank you so much. I will see you guys all very soon. Don't forget, the video will be available immediately after we're done here. If you're not done with your painting, simply go over to the live tab on the main Painting with Jesse page, or if you're on YouTube, you'll see it there archived as soon as the session is over. Okay. All right, everyone. Thank you. And I will see you all soon. Bye-bye.